Hello, I'm Sharon Bringelson, Marketing and Communications Coordinator at the Park District, and welcome to the Park Bench. I am bringing you Park District news today from the Civic Center location, which is the Park District's West Side office. This location hosts many of our fitness classes, Tot Spot childcare, sports, tumbling, and cheerleading programs, and some preschool, youth, and adult variety classes. There is a lot of activity in this building, and you'll find friendly and helpful people to greet you and assist you in finding the programs that best meet your needs and interests. Today, we have with us Jennifer Putzier, the director of the Batavia Depot Museum. Hello, and welcome, Jennifer.
Hello, thank you for having me back.
Jennifer, since you joined the Park District last year, you have added so many new and interesting programs. You have two different things coming up in March that our viewers will want to hear more about. Let's first talk about the Victory Garden and Seed Swap. What's that all about?
Well, the Victory Garden is a new exhibit that we're creating at the Depot Museum. As everyone knows, space inside the museum is a little tight, so we're taking it outside. The garden will be on the east side of the depot with vegetables they would have grown during World War I and World War II. Did you know that chard gained popularity at this time? It's hearty, bountiful, and easy to grow. We'll have that and plenty of other vegetables.
Very cool.
Yeah, one other fun fact, actually. During World War II, approximately one-third of the vegetables produced in the United States came from millions of individual Victory Gardens. These gardens, they put them in vacant lots, lawns, parks, even street medians. Anywhere, there was a little bit of green space. Beyond being able to send more food to the troops, it boosted morale of the families back home, knowing that they were doing their part as well.
What a great connection you are making to our country's history. How can people participate in this event?
Well, once summer comes, come down to visit the depot. But like most gardeners, we're also getting a little anxious for our spring planting. So we're actually hosting a seed swap Saturday, March 17th at the Lodge at Laurelwood. It's the opportunity for you to bring in your excess seeds, clean pots, garden supplies to swap with other gardeners and enjoy a nice morning with other people who also can't wait to start their gardens. So we'll exchange seeds. They'll have a seed starting station, and the Batavia Environmental Commission will be demonstrating how to regrow vegetables from kitchen scraps. Proceeds of the seed swap will go to the Victory Garden as well as the Batavia Environmental Commission.
Nice. Is there a fee to participate?
Yes, the fee is $5, and we ask that people do register in advance.
You also have a program called Carry Nation Temperance Rally and Bar Smashing. Very intriguing. Please tell us about that one.
I'm really excited about this one. On Thursday, March 29th, we'll go back in time to 1905 and meet Carrie A. Nation as she spreads her word about her crusade about the terrible influence of alcohol. Mm-hmm. You can see I'm actually wearing my Carrie Nation hatchet pin already. It's in the shape of a hatchet, which was her preferred method of smashing up bars. She really wasn't kidding around.
What's planned for that evening?
Well, we'll start out at the Temperance Rally, which will be held at Shannon Hall, complete with Prohibitionist-approved refreshments, of course. Carrie Nation will tell you about her life's work and her crusade, and of course sing lots of rousing songs and get everyone riled up. Once everyone's ready to go, the rally will then progress to Pile Joey's Bar, which of course sells the demon rum. Mrs. Nation, with her ever-ready hatchet, will show everyone how she earned the title of Barroom Smasher. It promises to be a very interesting and dramatic program.
It sounds like it. How can people register to attend?
You can sign up through the Park District website or in person at one of our offices. Breaking up the bar is thirsty work, so of course, with your regular admission fee, you'll get a drink ticket. After that, a cash bar is also available. We will also offer a hatchetation bundle. Hatchetation is what Carrie liked to call her bar smashing activity. So in her honor, we'll be offering a bundle that includes the regular admission as well as a personal smashable bottle and a photo opportunity with Mrs. Nation. The doors open at 6 p.m. and the program starts at 7.
Wow, that sounds like a must-see event. Thanks so much for joining us today.
Well, thank you very much as well.
Our pleasure. And that's not all the Park District has going on in the month of March. At West Main Community Park, our annual Easter egg hunt will be held on Saturday, March 24th. All the little bunnies are invited to hop on over to participate in the annual Easter egg hunt and see the Easter bunny. Everyone should meet at the pavilion by 9:45 a.m. Group leaders will divide children into age groups and take them to separate hunt areas. Don't forget a basket to hold all of those goodies. In the spirit of the event, participants are asked to please bring a non-perishable food item or paper product to be donated to Batavia Food Pantry. Hunt begins at 10 o'clock a.m. for ages 2 to 8. And for you dog lovers out there, don't miss out on our doggy egg hunt, also on Saturday, March 24th. Join us at the Bark Park as your dog hunts for treat-filled Easter eggs. All dogs must be leashed during the event. Pre-registration is requested, but we will also accept registration at the gate to the Bark Park starting at 11 o'clock a.m. that morning. We will have pet-friendly vendors on site from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. A portion of the proceeds will benefit Anderson Animal Shelter. There's a new time this year. The hunt will begin at 11:30 a.m. sharp. For more information, call 630-879-5235. Be sure to join us for one or all of these fun-filled events. March is chock full of exciting things here at the Park District. Check back to see future episodes of the Park Bench and hear more about the wonderful Park District events coming up this spring.